a time. Everyone was like, wow, this girl can move it.
She seems to be able to bend all sorts of ways, doesn't she, Sierra? She's unbreakable, that one.
You know, Sierra can do from sexy to, like, really hardcore ghetto South Central choreography.
I remember in the nightclub, whenever that song came on, more people would do the stumbly legs than
the
they
one,
would.
Two step.
The stumbly legs, that is called the crip walk. In America, they have the Bloods and the Crips. They're a big gang. And the Crips, as a gang sign, they would do this dance, and it's a crip walk. It's very, very hard to do, but you would catch me in the club doing that and doing the little one, two step.
You gotta punch, then crank back three times from left to right.
At number 31 in Pop's Greatest Dance Crazes, it's Soldier Boy, who is A, not a soldier, and B, no longer a boy. But what he lacks in basic honesty, he more than makes up for in sweet, sweet moves.
That was the twist of the 2000s.
Is probably the biggest dance craze of my era, actually, of my generation.
The first time I heard it, I was like, okay, now I need to learn this dance. I was on YouTube trying to learn it before anyone else and do it all just as good as Soulja Boy did.
This dance for Soulja Boy's 2007 hit Crank That might look good, but it's not appropriate in cramped spaces. Try doing this in the middle of a crowded dance floor and someone will lamp you. You're quite right too.
So Soulja Boy, don't bang into people, yeah? So it goes, woo, hey, whammy, woo.
I think you gotta jump side to side. Don't feel silly doing it. Do it like you don't care.
It gets a bit crazy that way as well, because people, they decide it's all about who travels the furthest on the woo. So everyone is hopping and woo about 10 meters on the woo, woo, hey, whammy, woo.
Superman and help. Because, I mean, come on, I mean, how cool is that?
If it sounds like it was written using a Casio toy keyboard, that's because it was, kind of. The DIY track was made in his dad's recording studio and released on the internet with a video demonstrating the now famous dance.
When I heard the song, I was like, really? It just sounded like one of those really bad demos.
These days, you can go and make your own music. It's as simple as that. I know 13-year-olds that actually make their own music.
And he produced it. Wrote it, made his own dance, got all the money.
The song wasn't all that.
It's true, actually.
Actually, it is really good.
It's brilliant, I love that
song. I do like it.
Soulja Boy holds the record as the youngest person to write, perform and produce a US number one hit. But when we found out what young Soulja Boy was actually rapping about, we were less keen on kids doing his dance.
That's a really dirty one, isn't it? I think it's meant to be what he's saying is quite rude, but we won't go into that because it's very vulgar.
So tell all your daughters and all your sons to stop singing that song. Soulja Boy, you should be ashamed of yourself.
At number 30, it's Bucks Fizz with their Eurovision-winning song, Making Your Mind Up. In a bid to win the votes of the more backward European nations, the song featured a routine that managed to be both childish and sexist. It culminated in the male members of the band yanking off the skirts of the ladies. Like this. Oh, your one doesn't do it.
Making Your Mind Up.
You believe that a love can hit the top, you gotta play around. I used to remember doing that in the playground. That was my era.
Just your fantasy set and pretend that I'm making your mind up. Is that it?
We were put together specifically to wear bright colours, to all be blonde, and to all do a happy little routine that would catch the judges' eyes. Don't let your indecision take you from behind, hands on bum.
Trust your intuition. Don't let others change your mind. Don't let others change your mind. See, they had a message, they had a positive message.
I'd leap onto mic, legs akimbo, run back to our mic stands, the most memorable part of the song. But if you want to see
some more.
there was a point where they whipped the girls' skirts off to show off their knees.
The skirts came off and that was it. History was made.
Lady Gaga, nothing. We saw Cheryl Baker's knees.
I'm sure that we won the Eurovision because of the skirts. We only won by 4 points. I'm sure that those 4 points were from people who were glad the skirts came off.
Making Your Mind Up got to number one in 9 countries, and the groundbreaking choreography was the cutting edge and cool for 7-year-olds across the nation.
Dear Jim Will Fix It, could you make it possible for my sister Nicola to appear with Bucks Fizz pop group?
I cannot tell you how many times I've been stopped by girls who've said that when they were a little girl, they immediately said to their mum, you've got to make a rip-off skirt. And they used to pretend to be us in the playground.
Guys, please don't pull their skirts off.
I always had to be one of the boys in it that whipped the skirt off. It's like, no, Shappy, you pull the skirt now. And I said, don't want to pull the skirt. Can't I be Cheryl? No, Tanya's Cheryl. She's got blonde hair. It was a shame. I would have been a good Cheryl.
Ooh, oh, phew.
Apparently, they run out of Velcro the next day in every shop.
I did want a Velcro skirt, but there's no way I was ever going to get one.
To finish off with ripping the skirt off, it couldn't be a bigger finale, you know, and the audience go, yes, it's great.
Then they followed it with a crowd surf.
Really?
No.
Oh, no.
Making Your Mind Up. Finished.
At 29, it's a Python-esque take on an original 60s skank dance, by which I mean this. God, it's knackering. Yes, it's madness with One Step Beyond. The tune was originally written by Jamaican ska singer Prince Buster, and it wasn't until... Oh, sod it. Watch the VT.
Hey, you! Don't watch that! Watch this! One Step Beyond!
I'm a massive Madness fan, and so you've got to do all that, and you've got to do the sort of running on the spot. It's just like drunken rah!
If you say the words One Step Beyond to me, the first thing that comes into my head is an overweight man jogging on the spot ferociously and occasionally flailing out his arms and striking bystanders.
It's one for the football supporters, isn't it, Madness?
You know, they're called Madness, so everything that they do can be as frenetic and as insane and crazy as you like.
Their Jamaican ska-inspired moves and high-energy songs made blokes everywhere want to climb on the nutty train. All aboard.
The idea of dancing had kind of fizzled out a little bit, certainly amongst white... working-class, middle-class boys. And in fact, my hand has been shaken on a number of occasions by people who thanked me, in part, for making blokes dance again.
When they were in the pop charts, I would have been 6, 7, 8. So all those family dues, it was just lashed up blokes like my dad going, right! House of Fun, you're bloody right, it is.
It really did make you want to dance. You know, your feet, you go with the drums, and your hips with the bass, and the elbows with the hi-hat, or something like that.
I would imagine they could bring out Madness the DVD as a workout DVD, because it is really energetic.
I think it burns about 4,000 calories every time you do it, so...
This is J-Ho, a song many of you all know from the film Slumdog Millionaire. For those of you who haven't seen it, it's about a destitute child who witnesses the murder of his mother, is lured into a life of slavery, then scrapes a meagre existence through the rest of his childhood before being beaten by the police. And on that happy note, some dancing!
Jai-ho was really the dance that white people went, I know a bit of Bollywood dancing.
The general Bollywood stroke bhangra move is literally screwing a light bulb. Yeah, that's what you're doing. You're screwing a light bulb. Maybe two light bulbs. Look at that, eh? Danny Boyle, I'm ready for Slumdog 2.
There was like some of these and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-boom, and then he got the scarves out. It was great, great, pure Bollywood fun.
Somewhat of a mixture of traditional dances with what's current. And you're like, oh, it's funky.
It's all in the arms, isn't it? Sort of reaching out and looking, and then reaching over there. Oh, no, it's over there, everyone. No, it's over there.
What you need to do is this on the dance floor for 3 minutes, and then put your hand out. I would love dry hair.
At one point, you just see this flood of dancers doing exactly the same choreography. It was so good.
It's such a great dance, and it's so beautiful to see, like, rows of people doing it.
Basically, any dance move looks amazing when you get loads of people to do it the same way. It could be anything. You could just be just that as a dance move. If you get 100 people to do, that'd be an absolute craze.
The Pussycat Dolls in saris, with a man who has written some of the biggest soundtracks of Bollywood movies in the world, put them together over a bit of Danny Boyle telling everybody that, you know something, sometimes it's just about what's inside, and you've got a recipe for greatness.
At number 27, it's Shakira and Wyclef Jean with their likeable pop ditty, Hips Don't Lie, which, if you think about it, is absolutely true. They don't say very much at all. Good point. Shakira, like Rihanna, except with talent. Take it away, Shaco.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on.
The song just made her show off. She was basically saying, look at me, belly dance for 4 minutes. Belly dance to the left, I'm gonna belly dance to the right, I'm gonna belly dance with my shoulder.
See, baby, this is perfection.
I'm gonna belly dance with my boobs, I'm gonna belly dance this way, I'm gonna belly dance with my head. She's like, she's just a belly dance explosion.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body.
Shakira's dancing style is hypnotic, it really is. I mean, even as a choreographer, a dancer, when I watch her, you just kind of zone right into that belly button and you go, how is she doing that? It kind of has a life of its own.
She used to do belly dancing in the convent that she went to school in, and apparently the nuns were very supportive. Who knew? Obviously, nuns in Colombia are quite different to the nuns that we know.
Note that Wyclef is adhering to the golden rule. Do not attempt the Shakira unless you are a fully trained professional.
Everyone would just dance with their hips, however badly it was.
They look at it and they think, oh yeah, I can do that. And then they end up looking absolutely stupid. You know, you have to be able to isolate your hips, your waist, rib cage, and your shoulders.
Her hips go like this, if you think of a snake, right? I will attempt it now. So it kind of goes up and back down. That was really bad. They kind of, I can't do it. They go up like this and back down.
And you know, when your arms are doing all of this sort of stuff, you know, at the same time, in opposition to your hips, it's tough.
I'm on tonight, my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel you, boy.
I work at Pineapple Studios, and I remember when Shakira came out with that video, that belly dancing class that we have in Pineapple, like, had 100 students plus. It was crazy how many people wanted to move like Shakira.
Belly dancing classes have long been popular with ladies of a certain age.
How erotic is it? Does it drive men wild? I wouldn't say it drives men wild.
Speaking on behalf of mankind, I have to say I disagree.
Are you hot? Are you turned on?
Not really. I'm gonna...
Come on, that's pretty good.
Very marvellous, very seductive, very sensuous.
I have attempted it. With varying degrees of success. The main component of doing belly dancing is forget any concept of personal dignity. That's the absolute bedrock. And once you've got beyond that, then
It's remarkably simple.